Hey folks, Indio The GuyaRican here. You may be experiencing some downtime and now looking for some entertaining reality escaping content. I know I do.
That the NBA is suspending the season.
Let's jump in and talk about some binge-worthy shows and movies. This weekend, I'll be returning to one of my favorite shows, season 3 of Netflix's On My Block. This coming-of-age comedy series follows the lives of four teenage friends in South Central LA. The entire cast is a sancocho of laughs with a multi-generational broth of goodness. Can you tell what I'm craving right now? The acting and comedic chops from the lead characters are spot on and definitely worth the binge. If you haven't checked out On My Block from the beginning, well, now is as great a time as ever. Season 3 just hit the streaming service, so you have 20 episodes or about 10 hours of content to get through before catching up to this latest season. Also on Netflix is the Spanish crime thriller, Twin Murders, The Silence of the White City. I know, that's a mouthful. And it contains the word silence, which unquestionably invokes the memory of another movie. El Silencio de la Ciudad Blanca, the novel written by Eva Garcia Sáenz de Uduri. Apologize if I butchered that, Eva. Is the Spanish bestseller that was adapted into this Netflix drama. The film, set in the author's hometown of Vitoria-Gasteiz, an old northern town of Spain, like founded in the year 1181, serves as the backdrop to the story of a criminal profiler as he tracks down an apparent copycat serial killer. All this while the original criminal is set to be released from prison for his 20-year-old crimes. There is a bit of old movie plot fusion happening, but I was engaged and in my armchair detective mode throughout. The killer reveal doesn't drag out to the end of the movie. Rather, there's the cat and mouse look into the action, giving the viewers a suspenseful anticipation to the eventual crossing of paths. I didn't have much invested in the religious symbolism that affects the serial killer's motives, but for some, it may be particularly intriguing. Be sure to adjust your voice dubbing setting if you're into the original actors' voices. Netflix automatically sets the English dub. I'm personally not a fan. In the Better Late Than Never file, HBO has a couple of series you won't want to keep missing. Stephen King's The Outsider just wrapped season 1, and this crime drama series has plenty of screaming at the screen moments. I don't want to give away too much of the plot, but Cynthia Erivo is one of the main cast members, and she does not disappoint. But in Stephen King-esque storytelling, The Outsider is a slow burn. So if you're willing to catch up, you're definitely enjoying what's in store. And for my Latinos, cuidado el cuco. And that's all I'm gonna say about that. Last, but certainly not least, if for some reason you skipped out on The Watchmen, I'm here to tell you, stop playing. Pay your 15 bucks if you haven't subscribed, and simply just watch, man. Or woman. Yeah, I went there. But it was just like a layup, you know. Can't catch that right now anyway, right? You don't have to be a total Watchmen superfan to get what's happening in this action drama. It's quite the remix of the 80s DC comic series, so you won't have too much trouble following alongside the ensemble cast, which includes Regina King, Yahya Abdul-Mateen II, Jeremy Irons, and Louis Gossett Jr. Yes, Louis Gossett Jr., people. Iron Eagle, anyone? Well, that's all for now. If you dig what you heard, give us a like and drop us a comment. If you have any recommendations on what to watch, let me know what's up. Until the next one, happy binging.